ఓం శ్రీ సాయిరామ్, ఓం సాయి రక్షక్, శరణం దేవా. దిస్ ఇస్ చాప్టర్ 15 ఆఫ్ శ్రీ సాయి సచ్చరిత్ర దట్ ఈస్ బీయింగ్ ప్రెజెంటెడ్ టు యూ బై మీ సునంద. ద కంటెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ చాప్టర్ ఆర్ దాస్కను అండ్ హిస్ స్టైల్ ఆఫ్ ప్రెజెంటింగ్ కీర్తన్, చోల్కర్స్ వౌ ఆఫ్ ఆఫరింగ్ షుగర్ క్యాండీ టు బాబా, అండ్ ద స్టోరీ ఆఫ్ ది టూ లిజర్డ్స్. In the year 1911, Ramanavami festival was first celebrated at Shirdi, and the idea had originated from the Urus. From that year, Hari Kirtan was a regular affair. The difficulty of getting a good Haridas for doing Kirtan on Ramanavami festival at Shirdi was permanently solved, and the task was entrusted to Daskanu from the year 1914. Daskanu Maharaj on one occasion dressed up beautifully to do a kirtan and went to Baba for prostrating before him and seeking his blessings. Baba asked him, "Well, bridegroom, where are you going dressed so beautifully like this?" When Daskanu replied, "For doing a kirtan," Baba said, "Why do you want all this paraphernalia? Coat, upparna, feta, etc. Lay off all that before me. Why carry their burden on your body?" Daskanu immediately took them off and placed them at Baba's feet and never wore them again. He was always bare from waist upwards. A pair of chiplis was in his hands and a garland around his neck. Sage Narada, from whom the Kirtan Paddhati, the tradition, originated, wore nothing on his torso and head. Carrying a veena in his hand, he wandered from place to place. Such kirtankars are not burdened with outward trappings of dress. Their sights are set on the inner purity of heart. Nana Sahib Chandorkar, by his word of mouth, and Daskanu, by his splendid kirtans, spread the fame of Baba and made Baba available to so many people. Daskanu used to graciously agree to perform kirtans without expecting any monetary gain and without undue obstinacy. He thus became quite renowned. With the grace of Sai Samarth, Daskanu himself composed kathas, which means stories of saints, and narrated them in his kirtans. It was solely due to Chandorkar that Daskanu first came to Bombay those days and started performing bhajans and kirtans of Sai in various places. Daskanu, by his inimitable kirtans, attracted audience who had different tastes of enjoying kirtans. He generated great enthusiasms of Sai devotion among the people, fostering love and faith for Sai, the ocean of self-rejoicing. Among them, there are a few who by hearing the kirtan get faith and devotion for God or saints. All those people attending to the kirtan of Daskanu appreciate and admire his presentation style, his singing, his proficiency in shastras and his gestures. The story of one such person in the audience is given here under. One Mr. Cholkar, a poor serving as a temporary employee in a civil court in Thana, experienced a sudden, strong urge after listening to Daskanu's kirtan in the Kaupaneshwar temple. He was a very poor man. Cholkar was poor and moneyless and was unable to shoulder the burden of family responsibilities and prayed to Sai Baba, "Oh, compassionate Sai Baba, please look after this meek, helpless creature." He, there and then, mentally bowed to Sai, the beloved Baba, and vowed, saying that, "Baba, I am a poor man, unable to support my family. If, by your grace, I pass the departmental examination and get a permanent post, I shall go to Shirdi, fall at your feet, and distribute sugar candy in your name." Mr. Cholkar passed the examination and got the permanent post also. He required money to visit Shirdi in order to fulfill his vow. So, he resolved to cut down his expenses and save money. He determined not to use sugar in his diet, which included his tea also. He had a large family to support and could not afford to meet his expenses to Shirdi easily. After he was able to save some money, he came to Shirdi, took Baba's darshan, fell at his feet, offered a coconut and distributed it along with sugar candy as per his vow. His heart's desire was ultimately fulfilled. When Cholkar and his host Bapu Sahib Jog both got up and were about to leave the masjid, Baba spoke to Jog as follows. Give him, your guest, cups of tea fully sweetened with sugar. Cholkar was astonished to hear these significant words referring to his secretive resolve. His eyes filled with tears of joy and he fell at Baba's feet again. Baba knew fully well his secret determination not to use sugar in his diet. Baba wanted to create faith and devotion in Cholkar's mind and said in even clearer words, Cholkar, your promised sugar candy has reached me and so your vow of giving up sugar is fulfilled now. Baba meant to say, wherever you all may be, when you spread your hand before me in supplication with faith and devotion, there I stand behind you day and night as steadfast as your faith and devotion is. Though I am here physically, still I know what you do beyond the seven seas. Go wherever you wish over the wide world, I am with you. My abode is in your heart and I dwell within you. Always worship me who is seated in your heart as well as in the hearts of all other devotees. I dwell in the hearts of all the human beings, in all beings created in the universe, an insect, an ant, creatures living in water or moving in the sky or animals on the land, a dog or a pig, I pervade them all. Blessed and fortunate indeed, he is he who knows me thus. Here is another incident that reveals Sai Baba's dexterity. A devotee sitting in the masjid with Baba heard a lizard tick-ticking and out of curiosity asked Baba whether this signified anything good or was it a bad omen. To this question, Baba replied that the lizard was overjoyed as her sister from Aurangabad was coming to see her. The devotee wondered how could there be relatives of a lizard and thought Baba was jovially telling this. In the meantime, a gentleman from Aurangabad came on horseback to see Baba right then. The man had to travel further but had to feed the hungry horse. When he dashed a bag of grams to the ground to clean it and then bring grams for his hungry horse, a lizard came out of that place, that bag. In the presence of all, climbed up the wall and at once went strutting to her sister. Both sisters met each other after a long time, kissed and embraced each other, whirled round and danced with love. Questions that arise here are, where is Shirdi and where is Aurangabad? Actually, they are quite far apart. How should the man on horseback come there from Aurangabad with a lizard and how should Baba make a prophecy of meeting of both sisters? All this proves the omniscience of Baba. Had the inquisitive devotee not put the question to Sai Baba innocently, how could Sai's greatness be revealed? But it was an excellent device of Baba's to confirm the faith of his devotees in him. He who lowers his head at Sai's feet with single-minded devotion will truly find in him his one and only refuge and protector, the doer of all action and the destroyer of all evil. Om Sai Ram.